See that? That water that got them already turned to ice. That little bit of spray that when I turned the water on, it got on my hand. That's how cold it is. All right, party people. Oh, goodness. Let's go get our trailer washed out. We're going to do it ourselves this morning. And self. Well, we can't do it there. She said it was broken. I got to go over here. I'll show you. I got to do something fancy here. Tug test. What I'm going to do is go out over here and come back in over here. It's like it's difficult to turn around. Okay. These guys like to wash out here, but you got to put a bunch, dump a bunch of quarters in. Plus, they got signs all over saying it's a $50 fine to do your washout right there. It's not a, it's a wash the truck, but not a wash out the trailer thing. Okay. Gonna wait for this car to go by. And that's us. Okay, make sure. And let's go. I hate these self-canceling turn signals do not belong. Self-canceling turn signal does not belong on a big truck. Because by the time I'm not done turning by the time it turns off. Watch. There, it just turned off. And you still got a 50-foot trailer behind you, 53. Probably sitting there wondering what the heck I'm doing. What are you doing, JCT? Gotta get my washout. In the past, I've always gone about 22 miles from here to get the washout. Unbeknownst to me, they have it over here. Self washout. $22. I mean, okay, I'll do it myself. Film it. Might be interesting to somebody. But it is awfully cold out there, I'll say that. Oh, bang my head. See, right now it's like 29 degrees. It's freezing out there. Okay, so it's nice to know this is conveniently located for future reference. When I come up here every once in a while to this customer, so, and we're required to, company requires us to wash our trailer after every load or before every reload every time, so. Ooh, I don't like that. So let's do, I'm gonna put it about, got a guesstimate because it looks like a 50-foot hose. Hopefully that's enough. Okay, and where's the thing at? She gave me a thing and a key to unlock it so I can turn the water on. So let's do that. Let me grab my gloves. It's coat. May have to pull up some more. I don't think that hose is long enough to get all the way in there. Okay. Let's see here. Oh, who puts a lock on like that? Just hang it right there. Yeah, okay. Frozen. Make sure the water works. Yeah, it does. Okay. Alright. Okay, where did the thing go? There we go. Not too sure if this is gonna... reach all the way down there. I may have to pull ahead a little bit. Hose looks short. Yeah, I can tell I need to pull ahead just a little bit more. Let's do that. Okay, pull ahead about 20 feet or so. See that? That water that got him already turned to ice. That little bit of spray that when I turned the water on, it got on my hand. That's how cold it is. Let's pull ahead a little bit, probably up to that third post, fourth. Okay, I think that's gonna be good. That's good. Let's go wash them out. Yeah, that's what I wanted, the back of the trailer lined up with that. Okay. Oh, look at all this ice. We got no water coming out. That could be, you know what it is? The hose is frozen itself. The person did not drain out the hose water, and the water inside the hose froze. It's not spraying out. Come on, man. You gotta drain these hoses out, party people. Yeah, shoot. It's rude. When you're empty, you lift the hose up and drain all the water out. You know, I mean, when you're done with the hose, you drain all the water out of the hose so it doesn't freeze. Great. Tell you what, let me see that. Let's try something here. It could be... I thought maybe this thing filled up with ice, but it's... Let's see something here. Got nothing coming through the hose. Maybe it's frozen back here. Let's make sure. Yeah, we got water there. Nothing coming out here. Oh, come on. I'm trying to work this ice out of the hose. Solidly iced up. I gotta go get my 22 bucks back, drive 22 miles to the washout, or wait till a few hours for the temperature to come back. Great. Okay. Turn that thing just a little bit, huh? Okay. There we go. Come on, babe. Get in there. You're frozen. So too cold for this. There it is. Okay. Now, she said I gotta bring this back and get my money back. Where'd it go? Oh. See, I'm getting Alzheimer's. This. I gotta bring back. Okay. Alright, let me go talk to her. Oh, it's cold. Woo, my ears. Lovely. Okay. Well, that was kind of a bust. That's fine. Let's go down the road about 20 miles and get a washout over there. Let me put a lock on the trailer real quick. Truck's a mess because we've been playing in the ice and snow. Look at that, how dirty it is. If you want to sponsor a truck wash for Scotty, then go to bluebeacon.com. I'll leave the link in the description. And you can purchase gift certificates for trucker washouts. And yeah, that would be very much appreciated. And I can maybe get you a t-shirt, a hat in exchange, and also a shout out on the channel. What do you think, party people? Is something we might be interested in? Buy a washout for your favorite YouTuber and receive some swag in return. And there you go. It's something I'm going to set up in the next short time. Let me know in the comments below if you like that idea. And sponsor washouts for about... I do about one washout a month. Or washout, a wash, truck wash, rather. I wouldn't do it every week. Some people do it every week. Depends on... I don't know, it depends on a lot of things. How dirty it gets, what the weather's like, and what kind of activity we get. We may get zero, what you call it? Maybe nobody's interested in doing that. I don't know. We'll find out. Let's go. It's asking a lot. Oops. Okay. Let's go. Okay, reload. And my truck, travel center, J, boom, let's go. You see this road right here? I used to come out of this truck's up and turn left to get to the freeway. And if we look at the sign when we come up here, I'll show you something real quick. It's 400 feet. Make a right turn. They just put the sign up a few months ago. It's right there. No trucks, no through trucks going that way anymore. It's 5 miles to the freeway this way, but it's about 7 miles to the freeway this way. See that? So it's fortunate that they put the sign close enough to the, you could turn in here and save yourself from getting a ticket, because if you got past that sign, you'd be in trouble illegally down the road, right? And a lot of times, a lot of jurisdictions will move that sign about 300 or 400 yards down the line. Before you see it, you're already past the point of no return, unless you want to illegally back up to get back where you're supposed to be inside and make a right turn into here where I'm at, in other words. But they put it back, they put it close enough here, so, and then also I can't, that stupid sign right there is blocking my view of traffic coming at us. Come on, I was waiting for you all day. Now I gotta wait for this truck. Oh, come on, man. Sit here for a moment. Hopefully it turns in there. Because you cannot go down that road. It says no trucks. There you go, there you go. I wasn't sure if he was gonna Sometimes you never know with these people. Trucking doesn't attract the brightest people sometimes. Case in point. Teasing. Alright, let's go. Let us go get the wool shoot. Now where's my JCT colleague going over here? That's right. Oh, he's just backing up. I'll get you. He's gonna park for the day. Well, how about some four-way blinkers, boy? When you're backing up. Especially when you're blocking the road, T-boning like that. I don't see any lights flashing. Nary a light is flashing hazard-wise. I don't get it, man. All right, let's go. Let's get on to it, get our washout. I'm gonna shower, do some laundry, and see what they want to do as far as get my next load. Probably be tonight out of a particular customer down the road over where I'm getting nearby where I'm getting my washout. I typically get loaded out of there, so I expect to get loaded out of there again. So we'll see what happens.